Hi students, coming to the next topic in the microprocessor, memory segmentation. So what is meant by memory? Initially, memory is the storage space. So which is used to store the computer's data as well as the instructions. Coming to the segmentation, what is meant by segmentation? Segmentation is nothing but it is called a subpart or some textbooks which indicates that means chunks, chunks. What is meant with subpart? What is meant with chunks? Simply, we are going to identify it. Suppose, if you want to talk about any small part out of the availability of the part or any block like this. Suppose, if you want to talk about any small part out of the available part, and this part is called as a simply segment or chunk or subpart. So, if you divide this type of segments like this or chunks like this in any out of availability part, that is called as a segmentation. So, the 8086 microprocessor has 1 megabyte of memory is there. That means 2 power 20 address lines. With the help of 20 address lines, we are going to access 1 megabyte of the memory. This total memory we are going to divide into different subparts, that is called a segmentation. So, let us see a small sentence here. A segmentation is the process in which the main memory of the computer is logically divided into different segments, different parts, and each segment or each part has its own base address. Very, very important. I will explain what is meant by base address in future. That means next slide. So it is basically used to enhance the speed of execution of the computer system so that the processor is able to fetch, decode, fetch, execute the data from the memory easily and fast. Before going to explain in this memory segmentation, you have to see how to see the need of segmentation. In this case, we are going to see need of segmentation. This is a very, very important point. In this case, I am going to cover total five points. That is the first point, easy to access. Second one is fast identification of the location. Fast identification of the location, means memory location. Coming to the third one, avoids the overlapping of the data. And fourth one is, so need to generation of 20 bit physical address. And the last one is power save. These are the 5 points which represents the meaning of the need of segmentation. Coming to the first case, easy to access. So what is the sentence which represents easy to access? Means the location is access is very easy with the help of segmentation. In this example, I am going to explaining the how memory segmentation will helps to the access the location very easily. Consider 100 houses, arrangement of the 100 houses like this. Suppose segmentation, just consider 100 houses. Those 100 houses are arranged in the sequence manner, that means serial manner, like this, in one particular cell. So, just 100 houses we are going to consider, so that the last house memory is 100. Just assume this is a 1, this is 2, this is 3, and 4, 5, and continuation, and finally, the last house memory is 100. So, suppose if you want to access or identify the 67th location as per our sentence, that means easy to access. Suppose if you want to access 67th houses, where we are going to identify, that means 67th house, just assume this is the 67th house. So, if you want to access or the cursor is identifies the 67th location, later you need to point every houses like this. That means first initially count the first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth house, and so on up to it counts the 67th house. Later, the cursor will identify the 67th house after counting all the houses from the initial house. Initial house, that means first house. So that means it will take more time. So instead of this example, let us take another example in matrix format. What is meant by matrix? It is simply which indicates the number of columns or number of rows. Just assume the total houses are arranged in matrix format. This is the first row, second row, and so on. This is the 10th row. Same as it is the first column, second column, so as it is, this is the 10th column. Same example, if you want to select or if you want to point in 67th house in this configuration, so you need to identify the 6th row, that means 6th row in 7th column. 7th column. 6th row and 7th column, it meets one point, that point is called as 67th place. In matrix representation, we are arranging like this. Compared to in previous case, the identification of the 67th location or 67th house is very easy. So that the cursor always need to access the very fast identification location. So instead of this this linear identification locations, always the manufacturer is preferable this type of arrangement. With the help of 6th row and 7th column, the automatically you can recognize the 67th house. So in memory segmentation, the 6th row is acts as a base address of the segment and 7th column is acts as a offset address of the segment. I will explain the what is base address, what is meant by offset address. The next point is fast identification of the location. In this case, we have to consider one more example. Just to assume auditorium concept. Let us assume our college auditorium. Two different auditoriums are like this. In first auditorium, auditorium number 1, auditorium number 2. In first auditorium, the students are sitting in random manner like this. So, but there is no fixed column and fixed row. That means these students are randomly placed in different benches. That means the total students are mixed with different branches. For example, ECE and IT and CSE and EEE like this. All the branch students are sitting in some random positions. Coming to the second case, different rows we are going to identify like this. Which indicates this row is indicates ECE. And the second one is the IT, and the third one is the CSC, and the fourth one is the TRIP. In the EC row, only EC people are sitting like this. In IT row, IT students are sitting like this. In same as it is CSC, CSC students are please sitting, and EEE benches, the EEE students are sitting like this. Suppose in both cases, the arrangement is in random in first case and one particular row in for one particular row is represents in particular one particular branch. So in our point is nothing but a suppose if you want to access ECE student some X roll number. If you want to access ECE branch student some X roll number. In coming to the first case, if you want to access ECE X roll number, the identification is very difficult. But means the all the students are arranged, that means placed is a different manner, that means a random manner. So it will take more time to identification of that the X student roll number. So in coming to the second case, so if you want to access the X roll number of the EC department, just go through the first initially go to the EC row and identify the one particular roll number that is called X. In this case, you need to avoid all the departments because you have to access or you have to call that particular student so that you have to select that ECU rows. That time the identification or accessing is very easy compared to the previous case. In this case, randomly arrangement, the student identification is very difficult. In this case, student identification is very easy compared to previous case. So that the fast identification is possible. Fast identification of the location is possible with the help of memory segmentation. Coming to the third point, avoids the overlapping of the data. Overlapping. Avoids the overlapping. What is the concept of overlapping? Previously, we have seen initial microprocessor 4004, 8080, 8085. There is no segmentation. So, in this microprocessors, always faced one particular problem that is called overlapping problem, overlapping data problem. What is meant by overlapping? So, while it is executing program microprocessor, some new data is placed into the previous data. That means once it is placed, the previous data will be erased. So, there is no one particular related data for one particular memory location. But in this case, suppose if you want to store data, separate data, only data contents. This data related information will be stored into the data locations. That means data segment. Suppose if you want to access some stack related data, this related data will store into the stack segment. If you want to access string character related information, that will be stored into the extra segment. So if you want to access instruction code bytes, those bytes will store inside the code segment location. So our 8086 microprocessor, the total 1 megabyte of memory is categorized into 4 segment: stack segment, extra segment, data segment, code segment. The respective data will store into the respective segments. So automatically it avoids the overlapping. Suppose if you want to access only data related, that means the cursor goes into data segment locations, it will access that particular data. So there is no possibility to check other segments while it is executing. So that if it is a code segment related data, if you want to access, the cursor goes into code segment location, it reads that particular data. There is no need of checking all the segments at a time. That means automatically it avoids the overlapping. So respective data will store into the respective segments. It avoids the overlapping of the data. That is possible with the help of 8086 microprocessor, not for remaining microprocessor. The fourth one is need to generate 20 bit physical address. Why we are going to generating 20 bit physical address every time? Because our microprocessor total memory size is 1 megabyte. So that 1 megabyte in the sense 2 power 20 address lines are always needed. So with the help of 20 address lines only, you have to access one memory location. That means if you want to highlighting or accessing this location, you need to generate 20 bit addresses there. But there is no possibility of the 8086 microprocessor at a time generation of, there is no generation of the 20 bit address directly. So that means, so that with the help of segmentation, we are going to generate 20 bit address. So coming to the previous analysis, our 8086 microprocessor total 14 registers are there. Each register size is 16 bit. So there is no 20 bit register inside the 8086 microprocessor. If any 20 bit register is there inside of the 8086, there is no need of the calculation of the 20 bit physical address. So there is no 20 bit register inside the 8086. With the help of these 14 registers, out of 14, if you select any two register, with the help of those two registers, we have to calculate the 20 bit physical address. So here, need to generation of the 20 bit physical address means there is no 20 bit register in direct generation for direct generation address. So you need to calculate 20 bit physical address with the help of availability of the 14 registers. The last one, fifth one, is the power saving. Power saving in the sense our 8086 microprocessor total size, there is no possibility to highlight at a time total memory, entire memory. There is no possibility here. Suppose if you want to access the data with the help of any one of the memory segments, you need to access only these segment locations only. That means this segment, example, that means extra segment, stack segment, assume code segment or data segment. This size is equal to 64K and also 64K. So you need to access these locations, so that you need to highlight these memory locations only. Out of, that means total out of availability memory 1MB. 1MB location means 1024KB. Out of this 1024KB, you have to at a time highlighted memory is these 464K memories. That means 4 into 64K 256. So 256K memory is always, it is a highlighted memory. The remaining memory is the disabled memory. That means not used memory one particular execution. So here the active memory is always 256K in 8086 memory. Remaining memory is accessed in disabled state. So that usage of the power is also very low compared to usage of the memory at a time. total. Coming to the segmented memory concept, just read these three sentences. Memory in an 8086-88 based system is organized as a segmented memory. The CPU 8086 is able to address 1 megabyte of memory. The complete physically available memory may be divided into number of logical segments. The logical segments are stack segment, extra segment, data segment, core segment. The selected memory is for stack segment, that is 64 KB, same as it is extra segment to data segment, and also 64 KB. So this is a physical memory representation. Physical memory, the total memory availability here. The total memory is equal to 1 MB. The total memory is 1 megabyte of memory. These 1 megabyte of memory, the active segments are 4, stack, extra, data and segment. The total memory representation is 5 zeros to 5 Fs. This is the hexadecimal representation. That indicates a hexadecimal representation is like this, HH. H indicates each 0, which indicates 4 binary values, like this. So, remaining 3 also, which indicates 4 bits. So, totally 20. 5 into 4, that means 20 zeros. Here in this case, F is equal to 4 ones. Here F is equal to 4 ones, like this, remaining 3. So, total 20 ones. 20 zeros to 20 ones. With the help of 20 address lines, you are going to access 1 megabyte of the memory. The 5 zeros H means this is the starting address location address, starting address location memory. And here 5 Fs H is the ending address location of the memory.